Nibble, nibble, like a mouse. Who is nibbling at my house? How did my house taste, by the way? I tried to make it taste amazing. I built it out of different types of sweets, just so I could attract people like you. Thank you so much for coming inside. Thank you so much for sitting so quietly in your cage. It's always annoying when the people I bring in make a ruckus. It's been a while since I've had a human. It's been so long that now I'm questioning what I should do with you. There are so many fantastic recipes. I don't know which one to pick. Do I bake you? Maybe a slow roast? Cut you into pieces? Do I use a type of brine? What kind of spices should I use? My mother loved to use brown sugar. Maybe I should try that. Let's see. Let me feel your fingers. You need to feel how plump you are. Could be plumper. How about something to eat? More candy? How about a peppermint? It'll help your breath. I don't want my meal to smell bad. There we go. Open your mouth. Do it. I'll just keep that open for you. There you go. Eat that however you'd like. Suck on it, bite it, whichever you prefer. You were so eager to take bites out of my wall that you must be starving. What are you doing wandering through the woods anyway? Spare me your lamentations. The important thing is you're here now. Going to have to add something. Spices, perhaps? Maybe I should sprinkle this on you. This might make your taste too sweet. What do I want? Something sweet? Something savory? Maybe spicy? I could cut you up into several different pieces and make them each taste different. Maybe I could roast you like a pig. Have a good old-fashioned sparnfarkle. But what would I do with your offal? Maybe eat it with onions? Going to have to brine you with something. Maybe this. This is an old family recipe. My mother loved brown sugar. I don't know. Might make you too sweet. But it would bring back memories. My mother would cook the best human. She was so good at tenderizing the meat. She had this meat hammer that she'd use. However, I like to cook my meat while it's still alive. I think it adds flavor. Oh, I should check the oven. Just about ready. We'll let it get a little hotter. I also have some nutmeg and cinnamon. What do you think? Or would you prefer sage, oregano, thyme, rosemary? Maybe you're a fan of Lowry salt. There can't be the classic of just salt and pepper, of course. I'm going to cut some strips of meat off you. Then I can cook them, kind of like bacon strips. Yes, I'll cut some meat off, and I can place them in flour and fry them. Still hungry? And you still kind of smell. How about another mint? There we go. You better eat the whole thing. Let me feel your fingers again. You're feeling better. Let's feel up here too. Much cartilage on the face, with the focus on the lower body. I'm going to squeeze your side a bit more. How about the thighs? Everyone likes a good thigh. I'm getting hungry just looking at you. Arms aren't bad. How's that mint taste? Does it taste good? You might have noticed that it doesn't quite taste like a regular mint. That's because it's not actually peppermint. It's a little something I've cooked up. It's magic. It's also poisonous. It's not going to kill you. It's just going to paralyze you. It also makes you easier to cook. Like I said, I prefer to cook my meat while it's still alive. And I can't have you trying to claw your way out of my oven. I've heard horror stories about other witches who've had their meals try to escape or start fires, push them in their own oven. I just like to avoid all that. I find that using some type of paralyzer is the best option. It also stops the meat from struggling and bruising itself. I'm just going to wait a little bit longer until you are completely sedated. Then we're going to remove a few things. So just a few things. I want to take a few strips. Maybe I'll make jerky. Looking a little bit sleepy. Don't fall asleep on me. I like to look my food in the eyes while it's cooking. Very good. You can't move. I've decided. Let's put some of this on you. There we go. That covers you. I just don't want your skin to dry out. That should keep you nice and moist. There we go. And on your face, too. I think it's time to start cutting. Where should we start first? Should we start by the face? I know this is going to be a little scary, but please, keep your eyes open. I want you to see everything. Get started.